So now let's try to check again by sending a push notification, and this time let's try to close this application and tap on the notification. And here you can see we have got the profile screen now, and you can just go back and you can see this is our home screen. And this is how we can implement deeplinking concept to navigate to a specific screen in our Flutter application. So we are going to see the implementation of deeplinking concept in our Flutter application, using which we are going to navigate to a particular screen in our application. So in our previous tutorial, we have implemented deeplinking concept, but we have tried to open a URL in our device browser. But this tutorial is a bit different. Instead of opening a URL, we are going to open a screen within our application. For example, we are in the home screen. We are going to open a profile screen in our application. And yes, a simple prerequisite is the screen which you are going to open should be added. So now let's get started. And here we have not added any new dependency. So this is the same dependency which we have added in our previous tutorial. And in this particular tutorial, I'm going to make few changes so that we are going to receive the one signal push notification. And on receiving the notification, when the user taps on the notification, he will be automatically moved to the profile screen. So now let's try to see the implementation. So this is our previous tutorial where we have seen the implementation of deeplinking concept using one signal. So if you have missed that particular tutorial, I'm providing the link in the description section below. So I suggest you to please go through this particular tutorial before getting started with this tutorial. So here in this particular screen, we are going to make few changes so that we are going to pass some additional data to our application, so that based on that particular data, we are going to make this navigation work. So before making any changes in our one signal console here, let us try to write the code in our Flutter application first. So now this is our main.dart file. And the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to create a profile screen. So profile.dart. And in this particular profile.dart, I'm going to specify a stateless widget. So you can make use of a stateless or stateful widget. But here I'm just trying to show you an example, that's all. So stateless widget. And yes, we need to import material.dart, right? So import material.dart so that our widgets are bin. And now here we are returning a container. And instead of a container, I'm going to return a text widget, and inside which I'm going to specify it's like profile screen. And also I'm going to make this to the center. So here you can see we have got quite a few options like wrap with center. So whenever we tap on this particular option, we are going to get a center widget wrap over our text widget. Okay. So now I have added constant to our center widget instead of our text widget. And yes, this is it for this particular profile screen. And we are not going to add any more fields here. I just want to show you how the navigation works when we make use of the deep linking concept using one signal. Okay. So inside the init state. So why we are making use of init state here is we are not going to make any action in our application. So once we receive the notification, we want the action to be performed automatically. So that is, whenever you tap on the notification, the user should move to the profile screen. And again, there is no button here. We need to tap on a button and then it will make a navigation. I think you got it. So now let's try to add notification handler now. So set notification open handler here, and now we are going to get open result here. So making use of open result dot notification dot here we have got additional data here. So what is this additional data and from where we are going to get this particular additional data? Don't worry, I will explain you it very clearly now. So we have considered additional data here and it's time to make some changes in our OneSignal console. So now let's get back to our OneSignal console here, and the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to remove this launch URL, because whenever you are tapping on the notification, by default it will consider launch URL and it will open the external browser and open this particular website over there rather than opening up our notification, that is rather than opening up our application. So here we have got few options like platform settings and advanced settings, which we have not discussed in our previous tutorial. And here now you are able to see additional data here and you are having add field button here. So now let's make use of this, and the key value I'm going to specify like page, and the value here I'm going to specify like profile. There is no change in the visibility here even though we have additional data, because it's not any display element. So now this is the basic thing which I want to show in the OneSignal console. And now let's get back here. We are going to make use of this particular key name here, that is page, and we need to make sure that additional data is not null, and then we need to find whether page is present or not. So the data with the help of the key value we are trying to fetch here. So whether the key page is present or not in our additional data, if yes, if it is present, then we need to fetch it, and I'm going to make it two string now. And also to make it much more easier, I'm going to assign it to a variable called data, so that we can easily make use of data in comparison now. So if data double equal to profile, then what we need to do is we need to just make use of the navigator. Here we have navigator dot push, and here we need to specify the context, and the next thing is root. So material page root. So here we need to specify this context which we have just added, and then let's try to move to our profile screen. So this is our profile screen, and this is the coding for the navigation, and this way we can just navigate to the profile screen. Hence you can just add a snack bar or a toast and whatever the thing required and whatever the element required according to your requirement. Okay, so now let's try to test this particular functionality. I'm just trying to run this application, and let's try to quickly see whether this works or not. So this is our home screen, and when you tap on home screen, nothing will happen because we have not specified anything, though it is a button. So now let's try to send a notification to our device, and this time I'm also going to add an image here. So in our previous tutorial we have not added any image, so in this particular tutorial I even want to show you how we can add an image. So these are all the options through which we can add an image, but now I'm just going to drag a file here from my computer. So here you can see our file is now loaded, and you can also crop this image according to your requirement and then save it. So, and you can see here our image is now appearing in the display now, and we have removed the launch URL, so that we are just going to pass some additional data and make use of it. And now let's try to send a push data, and now let's try to send a push now. So here let's tap on send push, and you can see the message was successfully sent to the test device. So this is our test device. And you can see we have a lot of notifications, but just try to tap on the latest notification. Here you can see it is showing now, and the previous notifications are 31 minutes back, which was our previous tutorial where we have redirected to a website. So now let's try to tap on the latest push notification, and here you can see we have gone through a profile screen now, but the screen was not properly aligned, and now I have made the profile screen to have an app bar and also a text message. So now let's try to check again by sending a push notification, and this time let's try to close this application and tap on the notification, and here you can see we have got the profile screen now, and you can just go back and you can see this is our home screen. And this is how we can implement deeplinking concept to navigate to a specific screen in our Flutter application. So I've just considered the easy to learn and the basic way of implementing navigation. So if you are having any specific requirement in your real-time application and you are not trying to make use of this particular concept over there, just let me know in the comment section below. I will try to help you. And the code for this tutorial is available in the description section below. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.